जय गुरु स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर टेकिंग सम रूल्स फॉर फाइंडिंग ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट रूल्स फॉर फाइंडिंग ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर. रूल्स फॉर फाइंडिंग ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर. नाउ oxidation number of free atoms or molecule. First one, oxidation number of free atoms or molecule is taken to be zero. Now free atoms or molecules, for example, if I take example of Mg plus Cl2 forming MgCl. Now this is a free atom, so its oxidation number is zero. This is a free molecule, its oxidation number is zero. But here you cannot put the zero zero because it is in a compound. The oxidation number of free atom or molecule is taken to be zero. This is the rule one. Point two, oxidation number of monoatomic ion. Now oxidation number of monoatomic ion. Monoatomic means things which contains only one atom is equal to the charge on ion. So monoatomic ion, you can take the example of aluminium, you can take the example of calcium, you can take the example of chloride ion. So whatever may be the charge on them, for monoatomic ion, that is their oxidation number. The chlorine oxidation number is +3, calcium oxidation number is +2, chloride ion is -1. So one point more I want to discuss with you. If you write charge, then number first, then you have to sign. If you writing oxidation number, then first of all you put the sign, plus sign, then you have to put the number. So this is the oxidation number of monoatomic ion. Then general oxidation number of oxygen is -2. General oxidation number of oxygen is -2. Actually, if I have electronic configuration of oxygen, it is 2-6. So it requires two more electrons to complete the octet. That is why general oxidation number of oxygen is -2. So general oxidation number of oxygen you can give -2. But there are some exception cases in the oxidation number of oxygen. Exception cases in the oxidation number of oxygen. The oxidation number of oxygen in peroxide. Oxidation number of oxygen in peroxide. Peroxide, for example, this is a peroxide. This the name of this peroxide is hydrogen peroxide. In this case, the oxidation number of oxygen in peroxide is -1. Now why it is -1? If you have want to know, then it takes one electron from that hydrogen, that gives you minus one. It takes one electron from this hydrogen, it gives it minus one. But in between these two oxygen having same electronegativity, so there is no sharing of electron, no electron is going towards this oxygen or this oxygen. So this here hydrogen electronegativity is 2.1, so it gives the electron towards oxygen. Here the hydrogen electronegativity 2.1 gives the electron towards oxygen. I think we have learned in unit 3 hydrogen electronegativity 2.1, which is less than oxygen electronegativity 3.5. That is why oxygen acquire a negative charge, this is the minus 1. This oxidation number of oxygen in peroxide is minus 1. Oxidation number of oxygen in superoxide, this is A, this is B. Oxidation number of oxygen in superoxide, this in superoxide it is minus half. The superoxide example is this one, for example KO2. Now if I have KO2 is like that, so this potassium having one electron, this one electron of potassium is shared among these two oxygen, so it acquires a minus half charge, it acquires a minus half charge. So this is oxidation number of oxygen in superoxide. Now oxidation number of oxygen in OF2, oxidation number of oxygen in oxygen difluoride, here it will be become plus 2. How it is plus 2? This is oxygen difluoride. Now in unit 3 again, fluorine having electronegativity 4.0, oxygen having electronegativity 3.5. So fluorine will take away electron, So fluorine will take away electron, that appears a positive charge for this fluorine. For this fluorine, it appears another positive charge. So in total, its oxidation number becomes plus 2. Whereas fluorine having oxidation number minus 1, minus 1. Then this is the point number C and point number D, oxidation number of oxygen in O2F2. O2F2 is structure is this one. So fluorine takes electron, this is plus 1, So this is how some exceptional cases you remember the oxidation number of oxygen. Now generally student, what happens, the oxidation number can be found with the help of electronic configuration. For example, if you have asked what is the oxidation number of potassium, having electronic configuration 2881, so it will lose one electron, its oxidation number become 1. So there are some exceptional cases are there that we are going to discuss. Next one is that the general oxidation number of hydrogen, this thing student you write down properly. So general oxidation number of hydrogen is plus 1. For example, if I consider HCl, H is plus 1, fluorine is minus 1. But in metal hydride, example is sodium hydride, metal hydride, the oxidation number of hydrogen become sodium hydride. If you take oxidation number of sodium is plus 1, oxidation number of hydrogen is minus 1. So if I have metal hydride, then it will be minus 1. Actually, hydrogen can take one electron. In that case, hydrogen become hydride. And hydrogen lose one electron. In that case, hydrogen become proton. So if hydrogen lose one electron, it will be plus 1. If hydrogen gains one electron, it will be minus 1. Here what happens? Sodium give one electron to hydrogen. Hydrogen gains that electron. That will become minus 1. So if metal is bonded with hydrogen, then that will be minus 1. If non-metal bonded with hydrogen, this non-metal means chlorine bonded with hydrogen, it will be plus 1. So these things also you have to remember properly. Now, general oxidation number of halogen. General oxidation number of halogen. Halogen means we have fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. General oxidation number of halogen is minus 1. If I take Cl, it will be 2, 8, 7. So means what? It wants one more electron to have octet configuration. That is why it is minus 1. So, but in oxo acid, the oxidation number of halogen is positive. Now oxo acid means what? Oxo acid terms means acid that contains oxygen. Now oxo acid means acid that contains oxygen. Now if I take one example, if I take HCl, HCl is not an oxo acid because it contains hydrogen and chlorine. There is no oxygen is there, so it is not an oxo acid. If I take HOCl, that become an oxo acid because hydrogen oxygen is there. So acid which contains oxygen, this is called oxo acid. Now if I take example of an oxo acid, it is HClO3 or HClO4. If I take, draw the figure of this one, Cl with double bonded O, double bonded O, double bonded O, bonding with oxygen, bonding with hydrogen. Now again, if electronegativity consideration, if you take chlorine having electronegativity 3.0, which is less than oxygen, it is 3.5. So you can tell that oxygen attracts the electron more firmly compared to the chlorine. So here oxygen takes 1 electron, 2 electron, 3 electron, 4 electron, 5 electron, 6 electron, 7 electron from chlorine. So its oxidation state becomes plus 7. So that is how its oxidation state changes. So here we have learned the chlorine oxidation state is plus 7. Now like this, this thing is note down. The next point is the algebraic sum of oxidation number number A for neutral atom is equal to 0. For polyatomic ion is equal to the charge on the ion. For polyatomic ion equal to charge on the atom. For neutral atom means, for neutral molecule actually. Neutral molecule means if I take KMNO4. So if I add the oxidation number of potassium, manganese and 4 oxygen, then I have to write 0. And polyatomic ion means and more than one atom. If I take CO3 negative, then oxidation number of carbon plus 3 oxygen is equal to the charge on the ion. Is this equal to minus 2? So this is how we have to know the oxidation number. Now I am showing you how to calculate the oxidation number in the next one. Actually, one question is that find the oxidation number of underlying element. If the question is like that, find the oxidation number of underlying element. If I have an example like that, KMNO4, you have to find the oxidation number of Mn. Second example I am taking, K2Cr2O7, you have to find out the oxidation number of chromium. So first one I am solving here, potassium oxidation number plus 1, why? It is 281, so it will lose 1 electron, it will be plus 1. Plus manganese, you have to find out the oxidation number of manganese, let it be X. 4, what is the oxidation number of oxygen? General oxidation number of oxygen is minus 2. This equal to 0, which implies X equal to 8 minus 1, X equal to become plus 7. 4 to the 8 minus, goes to this side plus, and 1 goes to this side minus. Now here, how many potassium? 2 potassium, so 2 into 1. How many chromium? 2 chromium, 2 into X, plus 7 into minus 2 equal to 0. So which implies 2 plus 2X minus 14 equal to 0, which implies 2x equal to 14 minus 2 equal to 12, x equal to 12 by 2 equal to plus 6. So in that case, the oxidation number of chromium become plus 7. So this is the two examples that I have taken. You can do many more examples. I think you will practice at home, so you can learn all these things. So student, you see, we have taken potassium 1, X, then 4 into minus 2, that can be. This is how you have to calculate the oxidation number. Thank you for today.